nomenclature and classification of viruses. So naming of plant viruses and the classification of plant viruses will be very, very important for easy conversation and exchange of information between the plant virologist across the nations. So now we'll see nomenclature and classification, what are all the rules and regulations that they are following for the naming of viruses. So my name is NH Shankar Reddy and I'm doing PhD plant pathology in Annamalai University. So first one, coming to virus taxonomy. So virus taxonomy is for naming of viruses and placing them in a taxonomic system. So here viruses are mainly classified. Based on phenotypic character, that is morphology. You know, or different types of morphology of viruses can be are there. So maybe rod shaped, you know, best example TMV, rod shaped viruses, or you know, spherical shaped viruses, or you know, icosahedral shaped viruses. Different types of shapes of viruses are there. And in a nucleic acid types, host organism, mode of replication, and the type of disease they cause. So the classification is mainly based on the morphology, that may be different shapes, you know, rod shaped or spherical or icosahedral or some other shapes. So nucleic acid type, host organism, and mode of replication and type of disease they cause. So these are all the criteria for the classification of plant viruses. So what will be the purpose of taxonomy, and what will be the purpose of taxonomy in the classification of plant viruses? So if you take this and the structural arrangement for easy understanding, so there are different types of structures which are there in different types of viruses will have different types of structures. So arrangement of these, all those structure for easy understanding. And the next one is to be able to communicate with each other. So if you have a common data on plant viruses, so it will be very easy to communicate between the plant virologists across the nations. And then identifying the properties and nature of new viruses. So if you have a certain rules and regulations for the naming of plant viruses, as well as you know, for model, it will be very easy you know, or to place the newly identified virus in a particular group. And then also useful for the study of evolutionary relationship. These are all the purpose of taxonomy and you know, classification of plant viruses. So now we will see some timeline how you know, a viral taxonomy or viral classification has been improvised so far. And I will starts with Johansson 1927. So he added the name of virus and the number of a common name of the host. So he added name of the virus and the number to the common name of the host. Let us consider tobacco. Tobacco is host. Yes, tobacco is a host. Virus. Virus means virus. It is a one. Then the as indicates adding the name of the virus, and the number to the common name of the host. Host is tobacco. Virus. Virus. They indicated virus as a virus, and then one, tobacco virus one. Like that, they had Johansson given the system. So the next one is K.M. Smith. He named and grouped according to the generic name or the scientific name of the host. Let us consider. The scientific name of tobacco is Nicotiana tobacum. Yes, Nicotiana tobacum. So Nicotiana is the scientific name of tobacco. Nicotiana virus 1. Nicotiana virus 1. Like this, K.M. Smith has given names. Then coming to Holmes. So Holmes followed a Latin binomial system of naming. So based on the host interaction and the method of transmission. Host interaction and the method of transmission, which was followed by Holmes. Example, Marmor tabaci, it was given by Holmes. Then in between 1942 1966, there are a lot of nomenclature and classifications could be developed through the international cooperation and agreements. So but there is no you know, exact setup or the governing body that can give the rules and regulation until 1966. Now we will see. Actually, we have already discussed what will be the need of nomenclature and classification. So coming to this, it gives a structural arrangement, and it can be very easy to understand if we have, if we identify the, all those structures of plant viruses, that will be very easy to understand in a simple way, and help to communicate between plant virologists. So identifying the general characters and formulating the same type of rules across the world will be very easy to communicate between the plant virologists. If it is not so, let me tell you an example. If some virologist has discovered something in Australia, so they have their own naming and classification or their system. So the same type of virus that will be found in India, so we also will name in a different way. So that will be very difficult to, you know, to characterize our, place in a taxonomic position. So to make it uniform, our communication between the plant virologist across the nations, this taxonomy and nomenclature will be helpful and enable the properties of new viruses to be predicted, and then possible evolutionary relationships also can be studied by using this nomenclature and as well as the classification of plant viruses. So at present, now the most important thing at present, we have two schemes of classification. How many schemes we have at present? Two schemes of classification. The first one is International Committee on Taxonomy of Viruses, ICTV, International Committee on Taxonomy of Viruses, ICTV. This is the first system or taxonomy that we are following now. And then second one, Baltimore classification, for the classification of viruses. There are two systems at present that we are following. The first one is International Committee on Taxonomy of Virus, that is ICTV, and the second one is Baltimore classification. Now we will start with the ICTV. So ICTV, what is ICTV? International Committee on Taxonomy of Viruses. Actually, this ICTV as a world name, or previously erected from International Committee on Nomenclature of Viruses, that is ICNV. This is the first governing body, the organization established for the naming and classification of plant viruses. The first one is ICNV, that is established in the year of 1966. So the ICTV don't have the perfect setup, so that the ICTV can be renamed as ICNV can be renamed as ICTV, that is International Committee on Taxonomy of Virus. Remember, these two organizations are same, ICNV. Previously ICTV is called as ICNV, then the ICNV can be named or renamed into ICTV in the year of 1973. Definitely this type of questions will ask in national eligibility test next exam. So ICTV established in the year of 1973, whereas ICNV established in the year of 1966. So ICNV can be renamed as ICTV in the year of 1973. As per 2012, ICTV consists of 7 orders, 96 families, 22 subfamilies, 420 genera, and 2,618 species has been identified by ICTV. So ICTV is previously called as ICNV. This is the same organization. ICNV is the organization which was actually set up for the nomenclature of plant viruses in the year of 1966. The same ICNV can be renamed as ICTV, that is International Committee on Taxonomy of Viruses, in the year of 1973. Now we'll see one by one. The first one, ICTV classification. So this ICTV classification will implement the rules for the naming and classification of viruses from 1990. So actually, this came into exist from 1973. So far, we are following the classification under all the rules and regulations of ICTV, that is International Committee on Taxonomy of Viruses. So whatever the virus it is, the order always ends with virales. Order always ends with virales. Family always ends with viridae. Subfamily always ends with virinae. Genus always ends with virus. As like of fungal classification, that is fungal. In fungal taxonomy, what will happen here? The phylum ends with mycota, subphylum ends with mycotina, class ends with mycetes, order ends with els, family ends with asti. But this is viral, virus classification. In virus classification, order always ends with virals. Whatever the order you take, always ends with virals. And the family always ends with viridae, subfamily always ends with virinae, and the genus ends with virus. Then we'll get into some, what will be the purpose and what are the contributions that add ICT we have done for so far. That we'll see. It developed an international agreed taxonomy of virus. So it developed an international agreed taxonomy of virus. So the taxonomy that was developed by ICTV is internationally unique. There is no changes in any country. If the taxonomy of virus that will be there in India is same, the same type of taxonomy will also be there in United States of America, that may be in Russia, that may be in some other countries on the planet. So the taxonomy that is developed by ICTV is unique and same in all the countries. So to develop the international agreed names of virus tags, so they have some, you know, some members or some, you know, international qualified scientists. So they actually have a great knowledge on this classification as well as, you know, identification and then morphological, you know, place up. So to develop international agreed names of virus tags that ICT were working on. So to communicate virus taxonomy decisions to the international community of virologists. So if you want to communicate between the virologists, the internationally agreed names or internationally same type of names will be very, very essential. So without confusing, the same names will be very, very essential to communicate between the plant virologists across the nations. So that the main to maintain the index of agreed names of virus taxa. So the same type of agreed names, if the name of a particular virus is there in India, the same type of the virus could be called as such of as a original name which was particularly reported in that particular country. So that to maintain the index of agreed names of virus taxa. So these are all the rules and regulations which are formed and maintained by the ICTV, that is International Committee on Taxonomy of virus. This is for ICTV. Then second one is Baltimore classification. So here the Baltimore classification, there we can mainly see DNA viruses, RNA viruses, and then reverse transcribing viruses. So in DNA viruses, double stranded DNA, double stranded single stranded DNA as well as double stranded DNA positive and negative strands can be there in DNA viruses. Coming to RNA viruses, positive single stranded RNA, positive or negative single stranded double stranded RNA, single stranded RNA, negative single stranded RNA, simple RNA negative, and then reverse transcribing viruses, single stranded RNA positive and then double stranded DNA positive or negative. These are the Baltimore classification, which comprises of DNA viruses, RNA viruses, and reverse transcribed viruses. In each and every virus, let us consider it's a DNA virus, positive and negative strands will be there. It is also applicable for the RNA viruses. He is a plant virologist and also the Nobel laureate in the year of 1975. Baltimore classification is a widely used classification for, you know, classification and the naming of plant viruses. He is a Baltimore 1975 Nobel laureate. Then we'll see some of the example. Double stranded DNA viruses have examples of adenoviruses, herpoviruses, pox viruses, single stranded DNA viruses. These are the some of the, you know, examples as we had seen already in Baltimore classification. The examples had been given here. That's it. Then we'll see some of the designations or abbreviations which is based on. So why these designations or abbreviations which are following, sort of for easy understanding, or the writing of literature in an easy way, or to communicate in an easy way, or to save the time, or, you know, for easy understandings, or the simple writing for the review of literatures, or, you know, placing of literatures, so time can be saved as well as we can easily communicate with these abbreviations or short forms. So now we will see what are all the designations of abbreviations which are given for virus and virus-like organisms, and what are all the rules for these abbreviations. So this abbreviation should be as simple as possible. Don't be like complicated as like of words, you know, lengthy words. It should be as simple as possible, and it must not be duplicate. In the sense, if we have given something to a particular virus, the same thing that make sure that the same thing will not be applicable for any other viruses. That's they are trying not be duplicate. In the sense, giving a name will not be applicable for once the particular name can be given to a particular virus, the same name, make sure that the same name cannot be applicable for other viruses, so that they are telling must not be duplicate. So that a word virus can be abbreviated as V. It's a very short form, like a look, word virus can be abbreviated as V. The word viroid can be abbreviated as VD. VD in the sense viroid. V na virus, VD, viroid. Then mosaic stands for M. Motile stands for MO. Motile stands for MO. Now we'll see some example. Cowpea mosaic virus. Cowpea. Cowpea. CP. Cowpea. Mosaic stands for MB. Virus stands for V. CP. MV stands for cowpea mosaic virus. And one more thing has been given. Cowpea motile virus. What we have seen in motile means MO. Cowpea stands for cowpea motile. MO. Motile. Virus, cowpea motile virus, CPMOV, cowpea motile virus, like that. They have given a shortcut names or abbreviation names, that is called, you know, short forms. So ring spot in the sense RS, RS means ring spot. In many cases they use RS for ring spot, but some cases they use RS for ring spot. Symptomless in the sense SL means symptomless in many cases, but sometimes they use SS, symptomless, like that. They have given short forms or abbreviated forms. The second or third letter LR means third letter in a lower case, represents the host, represents the host. The CDMV, codamum, codamum is a host. Yes, CD, codamum. M stands for mosaic, V stands for virus, codamum mosaic virus. In the third lower case represents host. Remember, if the third lower case will be there or second lower case will be there, second or third lower case represents host, second or third lower case represents host. So codamum mosaic virus, CDMV, codamum mosaic virus, where codamum is a host. Sometimes two capitals as an exception, like this here we can see CPRMV in the sense cowpea rugose mosaic virus. Cowpea CP, rugose stands for R, mosaic MV. Cowpea rugose mosaic virus, like that. We have given a short forms of virus, can be applicable for almost all plant viruses. So abbreviation for single word should not be extended two letters. So abbreviation for a single word, single word in the sense cowpea is a single word, cannot be extended more than two letters. If you take anything that won't exceed cowpea CP, motile M, so abbreviation of a single word does not extend two letters. You can see cowpea in a C or rugose or mosaic M, only one letter or two letters will be there. And in one more rule can be represented here, abbreviation should not go more than two letters. So the secondary abbreviation are omitted when their use would make the abbreviation exclusively long. Generally more than five letters, let us consider CGMMVR, which means cucumber green mosaic virus. Cucumber green mosaic virus, that is cucumber green mosaic virus, whereas you can see there cucumber green motile mosaic virus. Cucumber green mosaic virus, here we can see cucumber motile mosaic virus, cucumber motile mosaic virus, like this. Then geographical regions and then associated virus also can be named. And one more very important thing is in the names of the virus orders, families, subfamilies, genera, species should be written in italics. Remember, should be written in italics with the first letter capitalized, in a binomial nomenclature each name should be capitalized. Here orders, families, subfamilies, genera, species should be written in italics form with the first letter capitalized, as like of a fungi, bacteria and virus also should be written in italics with first letter capitalized. Very important, the remaining letter as usual. So other words, no need of capitalized unless they are in a proper nouns. Best example, tobacco mosaic virus, and then polio viruses, Murray river, and so like you can see river is a proper noun, so that's why they are used capital word here. Taxonomic rules, regulations, abbreviations are there. Then we will see rules for the naming of viruses. As I said in the first slide itself, rules for pertaining of genus. So rules for pertaining of genus is it's a genus is a group of species sharing of certain common characters. So here the one important thing that we have to consider for the naming of viruses, genus always ends with a virus. Genus always ends with the virus, as I told you in the first slide itself. So one more thing, subfamily always ends with virinae. Subfamily always ends with virinae. So make sure that while you are naming or giving the new name of plant viruses, make sure this rules can keep in your mind so that it can be very easy to give names for the newly identified viruses. So then family always ends with viridae. Family always ends with viridae. Then order always ends with virals. Order always ends with viral. So these are the some rules and regulations of nomenclature and taxonomic rules and regulations of classification of plant viruses.